T it will be continuous. T can have any value from minus infinite to infinite. Okay, this one n is an integer. Okay. Well, let's see. Now for the system. Okay, if we're talking about the system, we can have that the block diagram. Okay, and you have the input coming in. Sometimes you call that input it excitation signal. Okay, and then you pass it to the system. System is something that you okay, some kind of thing that operate, do something. Okay, the system will do something on the input and generate the output, the different signal. Okay, that which we call the output, or sometimes we call the response. Okay. Well, I think well, it's coming. Okay, don't worry. So that will be a system. Okay, you have a block there. Okay, that will be something. And okay, this can be the output. Okay, the input. Okay, I can say the input is XT. XT is the current. Okay, that came out from that current source. This will be the input, and this one will be a system. Okay. And then output will be the voltage that across the capacitor. This is R and that's C. Okay. So we can say, or from that one, we can change it in general. Okay. It will be, we said we will have a system and then XT and then we will have YT. Okay. It's IT. And then that will be equal to VCT. So, what is the relationship between the output here and the input? Can you give me the equation? From that circuit, what is the equation? Give me the equation that represents the relationship between the input and the output. Output is voltage across the capacitor. Input, it will be the current from the current source. Huh? What? What? IR, IC, that IT. Don't remember, huh? Well, actually, you know that IRT plus ICT is equal to IT, right? Okay. IR is what? IR is VCT divided by R. Right? How about the IC? C dVC by dt, right? And equal to IT. Okay, VC is, oops, sorry. VC is Y over R plus C dyt by dt is equal to XT. Okay? So that is differential equation. Okay, so that's the relationship between the input and the output. This is the output and this is the input. Okay. So if you want to solve for the output, you have to solve this differential equation. Okay. And you know how to solve this one, right? This one will have two solutions. Right? Okay, but in this class, okay, we try to represent the circuit or any type of a system using this symbol. Okay, we will represent it as a black box only. Okay, we don't care what is inside there. We will study about if the input look like this one, what type of the output is coming out. Okay. So that's the only thing that we will learn in general. Okay, so that's why I said this is not, the stuff is not new at all. Okay, the system. Okay, so now when you said, you can see that this is yt is equal to tau xt, the same as the one that I represent for the circuit. Okay, for the previous circuit, we will said the output, it will be the indication of the input. Okay, because you solve the differential equation. Okay, and normally, okay, in this class, I prefer to call input as the excitation signal. Okay, and I will call the output as the response signal. Okay, because excitation signal is mean that the signal that coming to the system excite the system, make the system operate. Okay, on the input. And then that will be the response that is coming out. Okay. And well, yeah, we already done this. Okay. Now the next one. You learn that one, right? What is the equation for that? If K, that's a spring. K is a spring constant. This will be the damping. That's the mass. Ft and yt. Okay. What is the relationship between Ft and yt? This one you pull that mass, okay, the output will be the displacement of that mass. What is the equation for that? Well, whatever. This will be the second order. This will be the second order differential equation. Okay. I will assume that you know how to do this, you know how to do a circuit. So you should be able to write this kind of equation. Okay. So in this one, if you represent it, you will say input coming in is a Ft and output is a Yt. And you represent the whole thing as a black box. Okay. Called a system. Okay. Well, this is another something that you will learn it next semester. Control system. Okay, in the control system, now the system is much more complicated. Okay, most of the time we will call this one a feedback control system. Okay, so you will have a reference input. Okay, you will output here feedback. Okay, and then compare to the reference. The reference and the system will try to adjust the error. Okay. This is something that we try to have the output exactly the way that we want it to be. Okay. If something happen, okay, because of this disturbance, make the output change or drift it from the value that we set. The outcome come back and then you will adjust, okay, at this point. And then adjust all the signal, try to make the output stay the way that we want. Okay. Okay, you will learn this system more in detail when you learn control system next semester. I think next semester. And this one, I think it will be Ajahn Buddhlak control system. Never change. It will definitely Ajahn Buddhlak. Okay. So I think this is a big picture. Okay. More than just a small circuit or it's just the small mechanical system, because controller can compose of so many circuits in there, the pant and then the sensor. Okay.